Hey, hi there. I am Subhash, product manager at Microsoft with Azure Files team. I will be talking about Azure Files data protection capabilities today. This presentation can help you to kind of stitch the overall data protection for Azure Files. If you're a new user or an existing user, don't mind. Look at this presentation. You will be able to find out what's new and what's available today in the data protection for Azure Files. So first up, let's understand what is Azure Files, right? Azure Files is a fully managed cloud file share offering by Azure Cloud. So it can be accessed via industry standard protocols or NFS or SMB clients, and also completely REST enabled for automation for 3P integrations and so on. There are basically two categories in which these file shares are offered. One is standard, the other one is premium. These file shares are offered based on the performance categorization. Standard being the low performant than the premium, but each of these offerings have unique set of workloads for which they attract. And that's how typically our customers choose between standard and premium. So if you look at it, standard file shares are generally best suited for general purpose file shares and user directories, et cetera, which are basically for your file servers in the on-prem world. And because of the ease of use and of the cloud file share and the benefits of the cloud and also the cost-benefit ratio, we see a lot of other workloads such as backup, DevOps libraries, build shares are being deployed on the file shares of late. On the other hand, customers deploying their databases, business apps generally choose premium offerings of Azure Files because of the performance and the latency requirements. Workloads like VDI, containers choose premium for their backend storage, again, citing performance reasons. So we have a lot of customers who use Azure Files in a hybrid cloud scenario with Azure File Sync offering. This basically would enable customers to stretch their on-premise Windows file server environment into cloud and access various benefits in terms of scale, agility, and of course, reduce costs when it comes to compute and hardware in the on-prem side. So we'll also talk about how Azure File Sync and its associated solutions help in the data protection aspect as well in the upcoming slides. Now, with that introduction of Azure File Share and its use cases, let's shift focus on the data protection, which is our key subject for today's video. Before we dive in, let's understand why would someone need data protection at the first place, right? And I think that's a no-brainer today to ask such a question also. And it's really important for enterprises today to have robust data protection technique because data is at the heart of everything that you do today. And data is basically fueling your businesses across your verticals. Making sure the data is protected against various data laws and corruption scenarios becomes really important. And more so important would be to protect data against ransomware, which is really hampering businesses across today. And it's of top priority for data owners to have products and solutions to protect against such disasters. And finally, data needs to be protected to serve your regulation and compliance needs, which are must to have today to operate businesses legally. So net data protection is top of mind to all enterprises, and it's no different for us internally as well. Our focus is to provide data protection to all scenarios that are important for our customers. So with that, let's quickly jump into some of the basic concepts here. So let's quickly brush up the concepts around RPO and RTO. RPO and RTO is a key number that you will always keep handy when you would want to decide on the data protection technique and solution that you would want to choose for your businesses today. In simple terms, RPO will basically tell you how much data loss you can sustain to run your business since the failure. RTO will tell you how soon you could be up and running after that failure. Key thing to note here is the cost of the solution really depends on your RPO and RTO number. The solution will cost you high if your needs tend towards zero RPO and RTO solution, which means that I need my business to be up and running in a matter of few seconds. And also after the disaster strikes, I cannot sustain any data loss. There are various solutions in the market that can offer such a solution, starting with snapshots or sync replication, et cetera. But one could argue that snapshots are cheaper, but still you're putting into a high cost bucket, but that's actually really true. Snapshots will help you in serving RPO and RTO, lower RPO and RTO requirements, but snapshot is not a copy of data, mind you. Snapshots exist in the active file system and can be accessed only until the production system is live. So we need to have an additional copy for the extended data loss scenarios that will add on to costs for zero RPO and RTO scenarios. Whereas for higher RPO and RTO numbers, the cost generally reduces. So we need to make sure we design our solutions accordingly. And we at Azure have solution that fits across all the spectrums. And then let's go over some of those in the next slide. So here is a data protection spectrum that Azure offers based on the RPO and RTO requirements we discussed about in the previous slide. RPO and RTO is basically numbers that can help you to decide on your data protection solution, as I said. Zero RPO and RTO solutions are called as high availability solutions, for which you have LRS and NZRS offerings from the Azure storage. LRS is basically a locally redundant storage, which can help you with the hardware failures local to data centers. ZRS is more on the zone redundant storage, which can help you with zero RPO and RTO solution with data center wide failures. And for customers who are looking for the slight variations in RPO and RTO, can look at cross-region replication with our geo redundant storage, with which you can expect an RPO of 30 minutes and RTO of 1 hour if designed appropriately. And it all depends on various other parameters like incremental data churn that you have, the bandwidth for replication, and things like that. And also we have solutions that can offer RPO and RTO in days through our backup solutions like Azure Backup and integrations with 3P solutions. So just to summarize, we have solutions that can cut across various RPO and RTO requirements. We just have to choose the right solution that is required for our needs. Like for DR, you could choose between LRS, ZRS, and GRS options. For long-term retention and ransomware recovery, mostly customers would choose backup and restore options. Here are some of the data protection capabilities that are built into Azure Files storage platform that can help you to achieve the RPO and RTO numbers that we just spoke about. The top row is basically account locks, soft delete, and snapshots that can help you in accidental deletions and malicious admin scenarios. The bottom row is basically targeted to create copies of the data to make the data more reliable and durable and available. So one should be able to recover data from any kind of disaster or corruption scenarios. So that's the reason you create copies of data. So we have solutions for ransomware protection solution as well with first party and third party integration. Azure Backup recently introduced vaulting capability for Azure Files, which can actually enable long-term retention scenarios for compliance and regulatory purposes. So we shall talk about this more in the upcoming slide. So here is just a sneak peek of what Azure Files robust data protection capabilities can do all about. In the next few slides, I will double click on each of these capabilities a bit more in detail. So we have protection across various levels to prevent accidental deletions, be it intentional or non-intentional. First up is storage account locks. This is really a cool feature that can enable admins to lock their storage account. This will prevent users from deleting the storage account, and hence the data in the storage account is safe and cannot be deleted at any cost. There are basically two modes. One is cannot delete lock, which means that user will not be able to delete or delete at all, but can modify certain configurations. There is another mode, which is read-only lock, which prevents deleting and also modifying configurations. So it's kind of additional safety for admins to against malicious admins or rogue admins. The other technology is soft delete. This can help prevent deletion of accidental deletions of Azure files at the share level. Basically, this operates at the file share level. So if a file share is soft delete enabled and is deleted, then it moves to a soft deleted state internally. So until the soft deletion retention expires that you have set, the share can be retrieved at any given point in time. So as far as billing is concerned, it's basically billed based on what you use capacity when the soft delete is enabled. Snapshots is other key capability which will help you to restore files and directories within a file share if accidentally deleted or in corruption scenarios. So you could have multiple recovery points to cater low RPO requirements. The share snapshots are incremental in nature and therefore very, very space efficient. So in case of snapshots, one would be charged only the incremental changes and that would be stored as part of the snapshot capacity. Shifting gears, let's look at the replication options that are available for HADR solutions within Azure platform. Azure File supports all the redundancy options offered by the Uber Azure storage. LRS is a locally redundant storage, which is opt-in by default. So whenever you create a file share, the storage account, it has three copies of data, which is stored locally in the same data center. This helps you against local disk failures or node or rack failures in the data center itself. Data is replicated synchronously across all three copies of data, so there would be no data loss. So it's a zero RPO and RTO solution. ZRS is the other type of storage, which is called as zone redundant storage. This is basically a high availability solution across zones. Here you would have, again, three copies of data. Each copy is placed in one zone. Zones are typically spread 300 miles apart. Therefore, ZRS type of storage will protect against data center-wide failures. And again, here data is synchronously replicated across all three copies in three zones. So there is no data loss whatsoever. The third copy is a GRS, which can protect against region-wide failures. This is a cross-region replication that is offered within Azure. The zones typically make up a region, and if the region is impacted, all zones within the region are considered to be failed. So GRS helps you to protect against region-wide failures. The replication typically is async replication and will have data loss. The RPOs could range from 15 minutes and 2 hours, depending on the replication bandwidth and availability and the data transfer size, etc. So one has to test, validate, before committing to any RPO and RTO numbers externally to customers. So let's now look into some of the hybrid solution areas that we have in offer to protect the file data. Azure File Sync plus Azure Backup is a great combination when it comes to hybrid cloud backup from on-prem to cloud. Azure File Sync is a native Azure service that keeps everything in sync with centralized file share and local file server or branch servers. So this makes file backup really easy when it comes to backup and recovery as well. Recovery can be various scenarios. You could recover single file or directories in case of accidental deletions, even perform rapid DR in case of hardware failures. DR is really simple. You just need to bring up a new server on the primary, point to the centralized file server on the file share on the cloud and access the data, and you're ready to go. Over a period of time, data will be cached and copied onto the local file server based on the file sync settings you have. So that's how easy the DR is. Azure Backup is other key native service which can be used to save backups for your centralized Azure file share in the cloud via snapshots and vaulting capability. So this is a popular use case, again, as I said, which will be used in a hybrid cloud scenario, and we see a lot of customers leveraging Azure File Sync and Azure Backup for doing such hybrid cloud backup scenarios. Another key solution area is Azure Backups integration with Azure Files. This is a typical backup use case where users configure a periodic scheduled backup of the file share to a blob destination. And then this will open doors to a bunch of use cases and scenarios that can benefit customers. Some of them are long-term retention, which is key for compliance and regulatory purposes. Ransomware protection is the other key benefit, which is like top of mind for all enterprises today. And this can be served by Azure Backups integration. Enable 3-to-1 use case. Again, this is a very popular and important scenario, which every backup admin will look for in the data protection solution. With Azure Backup integration, you could basically backup your files to a locally GRS-enabled blob account. And remember, GRS storage would help you to replicate the data to a different region. So in this setup, you can have three copies of data. First copy, your production copy. The second copy, your GRS local copy for your immediate recovery scenarios. And third copy is your offsite backup, which can be mostly your tape replacement copy as well in most of the tape backup scenarios. So this entire use case can enable the cross-region backup and recovery as well for the DR scenarios as well. All right, just to wrap up, here's a quick summary and the key takeaways from today's discussion. We found that Azure Files data protection capability solution services cuts across all key scenarios that customers today are looking for. HADR basically is served by the built-in replication options like LRS, GRS, and ZRS options. Operational recovery use cases for accidental deletions and corruptions can be served by snapshots and soft delete. Ransomware recovery and long-term retention is served by the Azure backup integrations and 3P solutions. Thank you for viewing the presentation. For more information for Azure Files, data protection capabilities, and portfolio, refer to our documentation. Thank you.